Lights, please. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign to you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And that's what Christmas is all about.
Thank you. as Pastor Bond needs to go up front.
Truly, O people, the Lord will surely be gracious to you at the sound of your cry. When he hears it, he will answer you, and he will cause his majestic voice to be heard. Good morning and welcome to worship this morning on this second Sunday of Advent, our second week as we journey toward the celebration of Christ's Nativity. I'm glad that you could be here this morning. Thank you for music and letting me play, I guess.
So, thank you for playing. So.
We begin our Advent season with the lighting of the Advent candles on the Advent wreath, and Albrecht and extended Albrecht family are going to join us to do such a thing this morning. Come on up by the Advent wreath, and I will get some fire for us. So I'll go here. Let me offer the blessing first, and then we'll see if there's two candles need to be lit, and there seem to be two young people here that maybe will help us out. Praise to you, O God, who gives us courage to start again. You fasten righteousness around our waist and baptize with the Holy Spirit's fire. Bless us as we mirror your mighty fire in these simple flames, and teach us to mirror your justice in the paths we prepare. We ask that peace abound until none hurt or destroy over all the earth. Amen. All right, I'm going to lead the way. You can pick any one of those, any one of those blue ones. Yep. Perfect. You get to do another one. All right. Perfect. And then just pull that little knob back, and it'll go out. There it goes. Very good. Thank you. The slide should guide you through our service as usual, and you can make reference to the songbook when we come to the songs. We begin with confession and forgiveness, and I invite you to stand as you're able.
Oh, am I wrong? I jumped.
You want to sing?
Yes, I did. So sorry. I jumped it. So sorry.
Wanda wants to sing.
No. Does that not surprise you?
No.
Blessed be the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God who opens the heavens, who draws near to us with salvation. Amen. Amen. God is patient and merciful, desiring all to come to repentance. Trusting this promise of grace, let us confess our sin. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Hear these words of assurance. God clothes you with the garments of salvation and covers you with robes of righteousness. In the tender compassion of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. God's covenant is eternal, and God's blessing rests upon us all. Amen. Amen. So we sing, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Stir up our hearts, Lord God, to prepare the way of your only Son. By his coming, strengthen us to serve you with purified lives. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated for our musical offering.
What God has done.
Some of the.
Playing it in B, right?
Is that in B?
Yeah. Yes.
That is not B. That is not B.
It is two.
That's actually, well, B.
B minor.
B minor.
I think it was
Yeah,
Dwayne.
B minor.
Sorry, guys. It was hurting. Too bad. I don't know if you heard it or not, but I sure did.
Yep.
I did.
Okay. Nope. You're good? Do that again? Just hit the person.
More? Just a minute.
Yep. I would hate to have this continue and you guys have to suffer through that. Sorry about that. We really work hard for these and I just want it to be better than that.
Yep.
Okay. Go ahead and play a note one over here. There we go. Good. All right. Let's start over. Yep.
Love incarnate, love divine, star and angels came the sign. Bow to Babe on bended knees, the Savior of humanity. Us a child is born, he shall reign forevermore. Oh!
all these transitions. I'm usually not a musician when I'm a preacher, and I'm usually not a preacher when I'm a musician, so my brain has to switch back and forth. Isaiah speaks to us from the first reading today, and he speaks a word of comfort to a people who are in exile in a foreign land, talking about God's promises being redeemed, God's promises being realized. And our second reading is from 2 Peter. Peter encourages his readers to be confident that God is coming, even if it seems like it's taking a long time. God's return is imminent, and so we should be prepared. We hear the word.
A reading from Isaiah. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem, and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the wilderness prepare the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a way for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill shall be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all the people shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out. And I say, what shall I cry? All people are grass. Their constancy is like the flowers of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades. When the breath of the Lord blows upon it, surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flower fades. But the word of our God will stand forever. Get up to a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength. O Jerusalem, herald of glad tidings. Lift it up, do not fear. Say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. See, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. His reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them in his bosom and gently lead the mother sheep. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We will sing the psalm in unison, and I'd invite a G to give us the first pitch. We sing together. Sorry, I'm trying to make sure that I know what I'm singing.
You have been gracious to your land, O Lord. You have restored the good fortune of Jacob. You have forgiven the iniquity of your people and blotted out all their sins. I will listen to what the Lord God is saying. For he is speaking peace to his faithful people and to those who turn their hearts to him. Truly his salvation is very near to those who fear him, that his glory may dwell in our land. Mercy and truth have met together. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other. Truth shall spring up from the earth, and righteousness shall look down from heaven. The Lord will indeed grant prosperity, and our land will yield its increase. Righteousness shall go before him, and he shall be a pathway for his feet.
A reading from 2 Peter. Do not ignore this one fact, beloved, that with the Lord one day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years are like one day. The Lord is not slow about his promise, as some think of slowness, but is patient with you, not wanting any to perish, but all to come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief, and then the heavens will pass away with a loud noise, And the elements will be dissolved with fire, and the earth and everything that is done on it will be disclosed. Since all these things are to be dissolved in this way, what sort of persons ought you to be in leading lives of holiness and godliness, waiting for and hastening the coming of the day of God, because of which the heavens will be set ablaze and dissolved, and the elements will melt with fire? But in accordance with his promise, we wait for new heavens and a new earth, where righteousness is at home. Therefore, beloved, while you are waiting for these things, strive to be found by him at peace, without spot or blemish, and regard the patience of our Lord as salvation, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand as you're able for the gospel acclamation.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Prepare the way of the Lord. All flesh shall see the salvation of God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. The beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, as it is written in the prophet Isaiah, "See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way. The voice of one crying out in the wilderness, 'Prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight.'" John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the River Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair, with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. He proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated. Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So, today's gospel reading, the very opening verses of Mark's gospel, the very beginning of Mark's gospel. And while Jesus is first mentioned, the beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, the first character that appears on the scene is John the Baptist. Every Advent season, John the Baptist appears on the second Sunday of Advent. And John comes to remind us of Jesus' coming to us now. We talked last week about the three ways in which we recognize Christ's coming in the Advent season. Christ's coming in the future when he comes again to judge the living and the dead. Christ's coming in history when we celebrate the birth of Jesus 2,000 years ago. But also Christ's coming to us today, now, entering into our hearts through the word and the sacraments. And John the Baptist is 30 years old at the time of this story when he's standing alongside the Jordan River. And Jesus is 30 years old, not yet having gone to the cross, but not the baby in the manger. And so John the Baptist appears in our readings to remind us of this third coming of Christ, the coming of Christ to us today, here and now. Through the gospel that is proclaimed, through the sacraments that are shared, Christ comes to us. And that's an important proclamation of the gospel. Jesus coming to us. I don't know about other phones, but one of the interesting things about the Apple phone is there's a compass on here. I'm not exactly sure how it works, because clearly there aren't magnets in there with all the little circuitry and everything, right? We know what a compass is like. It's a magnetized needle, picks up magnetic fields on the earth and points to magnetic north, not true north on the globe. And so you can use it to find your direction. It must be satellites that make this work, and it's beyond my knowledge. But compasses work well when we start talking about repentance. It's one of my confirmation examples, right? You know how the compass works, and you get it to that one spot, and you know which way is magnetic north or true north, depending on which way the phone works, so I'm not sure. And the other 359 degrees will not get you north. Think about that. There's only one way that you can get north using the compass, right? Now, even more so if it was a three-dimensional field, and now you got all these up and down directions as well as all the sideways directions. This is a reminder to us of how sin works in our lives. Because what we often like to say is, well, I'm pretty close to the direction I should be going, not like so-and-so who's way off. But the compass reminds us that we're 1 degree off. By the time we get out some distance, we are a long way from our mark, from our destination, from where we want to go. That's the reminder about sin in our lives. Sure, we can always compare ourselves with someone else who's worse than us. But if we're honest with ourselves, we know that even that 1 degree separates us from our goal. Our goal of full relationship with Jesus Christ. And that's what repentance is about. Getting back on track. Getting back aligned. Getting back into that closing that distance to renew relationship with God. Again, needs to be unpacked, because whenever we come to repentance, right, and that's what John the Baptist is talking about here on the side of the Jordan River, repentance, people get this notion that it's just about feeling sad for your sins, what you've done wrong. Repentance is actually the turning around. The 180 group didn't put down their poster today, right? But 180, turning around to go in the right direction. Now, hopefully not too many of us are 180 degrees off from following Christ. Like I said, even 1 degree is not following the path that is laid out for us by Christ. So, this all sounds like good law preaching, right? Get your compasses out, get yourself straight, follow Jesus, be on Jesus' path. If you just looked at your compass more often, no. Because that's a law preaching, and we know that the law cannot be satisfied. We can't make it happen. Because here's the problem with our compasses. Everyone who is born has a broken compass. The magnetism is all messed up. There's a magnet on the side. The glass is all foggy and scratched up. Maybe the needles are all bent, so you can't tell which way they're pointing anyway. Our compasses don't work. That's what we talk about when we say we are fallen by nature. Our compasses will never get us to right relationship with God because they're not working the way they ought to. And so we come to the good news. We can't get to God. Christ comes to us. Christ comes to us when we wander in circles, when we wander away, when we walk off the path, when we see Jesus in the distance and then get distracted by some sparkly thing over here or some exciting thing over there. When our lives lead us astray from the path we should follow, Christ comes to us. The prodigal son story should be a story of Advent, about the Father watching for us to make some sign that we're coming his way, and then he runs off to meet us. This is the gospel of Jesus Christ. This is the gospel for this day. Though you may feel as though you... There's two ways, I guess. You could feel like, I can do it myself. I'll figure out where the magnets are on my compass, get them off there. I'll polish up the glass so I can see the needle a little better, and I'll just pay them. No, that's what Luther called works righteousness 500 years ago, and it just doesn't work. But Jesus comes to us. We who have been claimed in the water and the word of baptism, we who have been grasped by God's love and the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, we who are made God's people, God comes to us through Jesus Christ, through this word of the gospel that we are to believe, through the sacraments by which we are nourished, with Jesus' very presence. The prodigal son story is an Advent story. For Christ comes to us. And while it still remains important to maybe pay attention to how your life is going, that was an understatement. You should pay attention to how your life is going. We do in fact want to follow Christ as best we can. We are gifted with the Holy Spirit, with the guidance of scriptures, with the community of faith that helps us grow in faith. When we fail, as we will fail, Christ comes to us. The Christ that is born in history, the Christ that will come again, comes to us today to be with us, to strengthen us, to forgive us. John the Baptist appears on the Jordan River, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. Today, your baptism brings to you the Christ, who brings forgiveness of sins. Today, the gospel is proclaimed to you so you might believe. Today, the sacraments are shared with you that the very real presence of Christ might come into your heart. Thanks be to God. Amen. With the whole church, let us confess our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Restore us, O God. Let your face shine that we may be saved. As you led Joseph like a flock, so now by your Son, lead us into straight paths. Bring us out of the bondage of our sins and plant us securely in your eternal promises. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gracious God, you sent John the Baptist to herald the coming Messiah and proclaim a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. In these later days, you sent pastors to proclaim the same repentance for the forgiveness of sins, and through them lead your people to trust in your salvation. Look with kindness on all who preach the word, that they may be diligent and faithful heralds of your beloved Son. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of all comfort, your word alone endures forever. The nations of the world come and go before you. Even kings and rulers are like grass before your breath. Preserve us from placing our trust in princes and mortal men. Give us rulers who will rule after your good pleasure, keeping order and protecting life, that we may live peaceably in godly quietness and honesty. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give ear, O Shepherd of Israel, to our prayers, especially for the family of Luis, Skip, the family of Georgia, Rachel, Taryn, Keeley, Tom, Jim, Olaf, Patricia, Sean, Boyd, Dave, Buck, Bob, Billy, Chris, Susan, Roy, Jennifer, Trudy, Carl, Lori, Bill, Penny, Dennis, Blaine, Judy, and those who name now silently or aloud. Give healing, courage, and perseverance to all who cry out to you, that they may find comfort in your enduring word and the certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life with Christ. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we know that you are not slow in keeping your promises. We thank you for your patience. Do not take your Spirit from us when we stray from your commandments, but convict us of our sin and draw us back to you in repentance. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, you invite us again to your table to receive the medicine of immortality in the body and blood of Christ, your Son. May we receive this sacrament rightly, that with faith strengthened and sins forgiven, our lives may be lived in holiness and godliness. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, as we in the church on earth wait for the coming of your Son, we remember all the saints who have gone before us and now rest in your presence. Keep us safe in your arms until you gather your people together in the new heavens and the new earth in which righteousness dwells. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
I invite you to share a greeting of peace with those with whom you worship today. Peace. Just a reminder, please fill in the welcome pad. This is the center aisle if you've not already done so. That's a record of attendance and communion for the day. As we receive our offering, once the musicians are back in their place, we will sing our song on Jordan's Bank, The Baptist Cry. Please stand as you're able and let us pray. Lord, in your goodness, be pleased with our prayers and offerings. And since we can merit nothing by ourselves, come to our rescue with your mercy. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to
give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and in all places offer thanks and praise to you, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and ever-living God. You comforted your people with the promise of the Redeemer, through whom you will also make all things new in the day when he comes again to judge the world in righteousness. And so with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy One, the beginning and the end, the giver of life, blessed are you for the birth of creation. Blessed are you in the darkness and in the light. Blessed are you for your promise to your people. Blessed are you in the prophets' hopes and dreams. Blessed are you for Mary's openness to your will. Blessed are you for your son Jesus, the Word made flesh. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. With this bread and cup, we remember your word dwelling among us, full of grace and truth. We remember our new birth in his death and resurrection. We look with hope for his coming. Come, Amen. Lord Jesus. Holy God, we long for your spirit. Come among us. Bless this meal. May your word take flesh in us. Awaken your people. Fill us with your light. Bring the gift of peace on earth.
Amen.
Come, Holy Spirit. All praise and glory are yours, Holy One of Israel, Word of God incarnate, power of the Most High, one God, now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. In this meal, righteousness and peace meet together. Come, take your place at the table. Thanks be to God. Please be seated as we sing the Lamb of God.